All right, we are looking at the chorai bhaji, better known as spinach, also known as bhaji that you kalalu bhaji. Yeah, man. So I have been cultivating this crop of bhaji here, and it is now ready for picking. And you see that little bug there? That is a bush bug. And the other one here is like a ladybug, but these bugs is usually come here in the nice healthy bhaji and cut themselves a nice meal. Now when you take this in the market for sale, the customers like to buy the bhaji which has holes in it, knowing fully well that these bugs could eat the plant because it have no chemicals in it. So I'm going to make myself a nice little meal. I'm going to cut them here now and prepare them, because I would like to feel like Popeye, you know, because Popeye does usually eat this bhaji and get the strength and energy to beat up Brutus. So hold on for a minute there. See what I'm talking about? This is a nice bhaji, man. This is the thing for you. This is just enough for me and the missus. There you go. So when you go by the bees, you have enough energy for the whole ordeal that you might have to go through by the bees there. Alright, so look at how nice all these nice stems are, man. You're getting plenty of energy from that, you know. Now you're peeling this like how you would peel the other type of kalalu bush. Peel off the skin. They have a kind of thin skin here that you could peel off, and it go down real nice, buddy. Real nice. Put a little coconut milk in it and you're good to go. Alright, later. I can't wait to cook this thing now. So we'll catch you in the next one.
We ride with the Huns. We ride with the Huns.
Yeah, man. It's nice, very nice that you could come back and check with me. Okay, so let me give you a little rundown. Today is Thursday, July 23rd, 2020. Right here at the Good Honey Bee Yard. And this morning, it's what, 5:30 a.m. And it's partially cloudy, 50% cloud cover. The temperature is 23 degrees Celsius. The humidity is 94%. The UV index is none. And the wind speed is very calm. Visibility is 16 kilometers. And what I'm going to be doing today. Oh my, look at that. The paracletes passing in the sky there, boy. You know what it has been saying there? They're going to work. Yeah, man, look at them. A whole bunch of them. Yeah, look at them. Wow. You've seen them? A lot of paracletes, boy. Anyhow, let's get back to this business here. When I get up in the morning, early, most times, I'm coming here to check, especially now. We have been having a lot of rain over the past couple of days again. Particularly last night, we had rain most of the night. And as you can see, the bees here, they're clustering on the outside pretty nicely. This colony here will need to get
a little reducing the entrance. And this is how I just know how to reduce the entrance by how much. More parking space. All they're going to work. Look at them. A whole bunch of them, you know. Oh, so wonderful. Look at nature. Eh? Right, so when I get up early in the morning and I come across here, well, more or less in the night. Eh? All right, look at this colony here. I will need to reduce it. Although it have a little beard there. But, you see when they begin to look like they don't have no amount of bees bearding on the outside, that is when I like to reduce it a bit. To ensure that they could protect their colonies easy without any much problem. So this one in particular, you notice inside, you're not seeing much bees there. All right, so I will reduce this one here by this amount. So at least right now, I could put it in and I'm seeing bees coming in. They're coming in with pollen and thing. Eh? So I'll put it in right here, just like that. Right, so they'll have that space there now available to guard. You see, I had already reduced this one some time ago. So that one don't need reducing. This one don't need reducing. But this one here need reducing. You see, when you look on the inside, let me see if I can get a little light here for you. See? So you can see the garden from here to here. Right? So I will reduce that other area there. And I have the piece of reducer here. So I'll just stick it in on this side. So actually, they're working on the side there that I just showed you. They're working on that side over there. So before they start stinging me, let me get cracking and fix them up nicely. Wow. See where they're coming out there? What? You smell me, you know? All the others don't need reducing. So that is what I do to keep the colonies strong and help them to protect themselves during these times. And I could tell you one time, I'm getting away with filming them like this because outside cool. So there you have it. It have a lot of entrance, back entrance here in some of these colonies. I ain't paying them no mind. But that is the case. That is the case of the missing link right here. And that is what I do to keep my colonies strong and keep them in that order. I'll have to get another piece of shim. Shim for that. But the shim I use is, you know, metal now. It's those thin sheets that are cut. I make those little entrance reducing shim. I have a bee trying to sting me here, but me. I hope you'll get me. Coming up today, I'll be doing another. I have two more treatments of bee venom therapy to apply on myself, and coming up today, I'll be applying the second to last one. I'm feeling pretty good, you know, but doing it over the years, I know that I still need a little bit of bee venom. So stay tuned for that. All right, folks. So I'll sign off right now, and I'll come back to you in the next one. Okay, TTFN.